Well, they're finally seniors, and Tarkus and Marcus and Godwin have been the main nucleus of building this program back up, and I want to see them get the reward of it. That's what you're supposed to get, and they've got to be great leaders. They've been through the battles, and I've seen it this summer. They are growing up, and reality is hitting them that this is it. And so what we've got to get out of all three of those guys is a consistency every night of what they bring. And I saw it last year. I even saw it as sophomores. But they've got to take it to a different level this year.
Obviously, finishing 3-26 is quite humbling. And we are extremely excited about beginning year number two because it gives us an opportunity to raise the bar here at UIC. Obviously, whenever you finish last and you don't get invited to conference tournament, that helps you to have a chip on your shoulder. And so as we begin year number two, we are confident that we have a solid group. We have 7 newcomers, and so we're really, really excited about the opportunity to get out and compete not just, hey, the ball goes in the air and we're here, but compete to win a game. And so right now we're working extremely hard. Can't predict how many wins or losses we'll have, but I am determined and I am really, really sure that it'll be different, definitely different. And so we're still gonna press. We're gonna get up and press, and we'll run a spread offense where we are looking to get the ball down, obviously downhill, but a lot of things that's predicated on teamwork. So somebody's gotta be able to turn the corner and dish it to players that are open, preferably shooters that can shoot the three, if not a couple dump passes to post players making layups. I think that Jada is beginning her junior campaign, and we believe that she has the potential to be a Horizon League player of the year.
Your ultimate, every team starts with the idea of winning the Horizon League and then going to the NCAA tournament. And when you're in a one bid league, I don't know that you can always measure the success of your season of did you go to the NCAA tournament. And you know, so for us, the beginning's going to be a Horizon League championship, the regular season. And that's what these guys have got their sights set on.
So the great thing about newcomers is, I would say, they don't know what they don't know. So youthful ignorance, I would call it, is great. Or it depends on how you want to look at it, but I'll say this much. They don't know who Green Bay Wright State is, and so they don't go in like, oh my gosh, they beat us last year by 50, 60 points. They go in believing that they can win every game. And so what we're really excited about is that the young ladies who have made the commitment to come to UIC and be a part of my vision, they're ready to play. They're ready to give it all they have. And our enthusiasm, our intensity in practice has been completely different than last year. And while we know that we'll make some mistakes, the most important thing is that we learn from our mistakes. And I do believe that every day we'll work, we'll be a better team, and we'll see the results later. Obviously, with any young team, there will be an enormous amount of mistakes, but we're grateful that we have a non-conference schedule that's really, really tough. We'll have 3 BCS teams, and so it'll prepare us for the conference. Our thing is that we just want to achieve and reach different milestones every game. And so we are excited because our milestones may be different than others, but we're just focusing on each day, each game at a time.
I think the fact that we have a great nucleus back, and when you have leadership at this level and you have older guys at this level, it creates a different environment in your practices, in the games. And you know, we talk a lot about Marcus and Tarkus and Godwin, but we've got Michael Diggins, we've got Jacob Wiley. We've got a lot of guys that have played a lot of minutes in this league, and so we've got Travell. He hit the game winner at Wright State on ESPN. We've got guys that have been in the battles, and so I think more than anything, the fun part for us is when I took this job, we were at the bottom, and now we're back to the point these last couple of years everybody's expecting us to be up in the upper echelon of this league. And yet I look around the league and I know it's going to be really good, but I think we've got great depth. I think we'll be 10 deep. I think we've got shooters all over the court. Jamie L, the Australian kid, got better and better as the year went on. I can keep going down the line, and we've got a lot of veteran pieces to throw out there at any time. And so it's what gives our fans excitement, gives me excitement, and I know our team's excited about this league this year. It's going to be a lot of fun.
We're young, and so once again, young people don't know how much it takes, how much it costs to be like really, really good. And so they play off of athleticism, talent. They play off of wishful thinking. For us, we want to channel that energy because they're young and they think that, hey, we're David. We could slay Goliath. Like, yeah, so we're running with that. And I think that what's great for us is that we have returners that have played significant minutes. And so since they played significant minutes, we'll be able to blend, you know, their talent and a newcomer's talent. And I think we'll have a pretty balanced team. Whereas last year, we had our top two leading scorers. They were averaging double figures, and everyone else was well below. And so I think we'll have much more of a balanced attack. Defensively, we're going to try to score the ball from our defense. And then offensively, I think that our kids will be able to let the ball flow because we'll expend quite a bit of energy on the defensive side, get some defensive stops.